Okay, hey guys, what I'm going to try to do today is build a ring light. I know they make some with LEDs that go right around a macro lens, you know, more for a close-up shooting, but my daughter loves to sing, and you see in the music videos that perfect circular catch light in their eyes. Well, I saw other people make something similar to this, so I thought I'm going to give it a shot here too. And fill you in on how I did it. Okay, well basically I started off with a 2 foot by eventually a 2 foot scrap sheet of plywood, and this is 1/2 inch plywood, and then pounded a nail in the center, you know, the old pencil and string trick, made a circle to maximize the 2 foot dimension, and then bought a bunch of these, 12 actually, of these kind of plastic light bulb sockets, and kind of figured out what their spacing would be, and then just made a circle on the inside, which eventually I will cut this out, and this is what the camera lens will kind of shoot through. So the plywood was free. These were about $1 a piece. I also have a 600 watt dimmer switch. This was about $7, and then some wire here that I'll eventually staple on the back, and that was about $10. So I don't know, $27, $30, something like that is what this is going to cost me, plus some of my time. Okay, so I just eyeballed where these will go, and then I'm just going to take a pencil and outline around these sockets, find where the center is, and drill a hole, because that's where I'll feed the wires through and then connect them to each other sort of in a daisy chain fashion, and eventually to the dimmer. Okay, I'm gonna start drilling the holes now, and I figure bigger is better, so I'm using a 1-inch spade bit here. You got to remember to charge your tools. Okay, got the holes drilled. One thing I would recommend is drilling halfway through on each side, especially when you're using plywood. Otherwise, you're going to get some big rips like this, which isn't pretty. But the other thing that I like to do, I think it's important to have a clean shop. So because of that, I'm going to be cutting wood outside. Okay, the perimeter's been cut, the inside's been cut. Now I've got to get to sanding. And one thing that I've learned as a good carpenter is that you have to be flexible, and that idea of keeping a clean shop when it's 20 degrees outside, not worth it. So here's another tool that I always wanted, used once, it's going to be used twice. And again, never forget these, your safety glasses. Okay, so I'm starting to put the sockets on the board now, and how I started is I stripped some wire about 11 inch lengths, assembled 2 per socket, and then screwed the socket in place, slid the wires through, and then hopefully I'll just assemble or wire up this next socket, slide these wires through, and go all the way around. Okay, well, I have everything installed. I have the wires connected, and then I used these little kind of clips to make it all nice and tidy on the back. I bolted in the dimmer switch, and then just an old extension cord that I wired up. So, put some bulbs in, see how that looks. Okay, let's give it a shot. pretty good. Now to try it on a person. All right, well, I forgot about mounting this. How do I actually use it? So I took an old light bracket, one of those halogen work lights, took the light itself off, and then made this bracket, just some steel I had lying around, bent it 90 degrees, bolted it to the light, and then just pinched it into the top where the halogen light was. It's a little wobbly, but I'm hoping that once I get it into place, it won't move. So, okay, now let's give it a try. Thank you.